Hello to you from ChemHelp ASAP. An important idea that affects C13 NMR spectroscopy is the abundance of the C13 isotope. Let's see what that effect is. Again, we'll start by talking about proton NMR. Proton NMR relies on the hydrogen 1 isotope, which is 99% abundant. So 99% of all hydrogen atoms are the hydrogen 1 isotope, also called protium. About 1% are the hydrogen 2 or deuterium isotope. In proton NMR, since you are looking at a very abundant isotope, the signal from the sample tends to be strong, and the signal-to-noise levels are high. In practice, this means you can acquire a spectrum quickly, and the baseline of the spectrum tends to be nice and flat. Here is a sample proton NMR spectrum. This is aspirin. The baseline is nice and smooth. I'm not saying every proton spectrum looks just like this, but most do, and it's because of the high abundance of the hydrogen 1 isotope. How about carbon? Carbon atoms are about 99% the carbon-12 isotope, which is not an NMR active isotope. Instead, we visualize the carbon-13 nucleus with just 1% abundance. The signal from our sample for a C13 spectrum is much weaker relative to a proton spectrum. The signal-to-noise value is also much lower. Here is a sample C13 spectrum. The baseline is more jagged. It may just look like a thicker line than the proton spectrum, but the thickness of that line is from the high noise level in the baseline. It's not terrible, but a bit rough. This is part of the charm of C13 NMR spectroscopy. Let's see some consequences of this relatively high noise level. One consequence is that C13 spectra take longer to acquire. To minimize noise in the baseline, one normally acquires the same spectrum over and over and over again and adds the spectra together to get a final spectrum. The random noise tends to average out, get smaller, while the true signal consistently grows. People use this method with proton NMR too, but C13 requires many more spectra with a cost of taking much longer to acquire a C13 spectrum. You might need 10 minutes to get a proton spectrum. A C13 spectrum might require an hour. Sometimes you can prepare a sample with a higher concentration to improve the signal strength, but this option is not always feasible. Because of the noisy baseline, C13 is not as useful as proton NMR for determining compound purity. The signal from a 5% impurity might not be distinguishable from the baseline noise. Finally, I'll note that some carbons, particularly quaternary carbons with no hydrogens attached, tend to give weaker signals in C13 spectra. With a noisy baseline, it can sometimes be difficult to see the quaternary signals distinctly without gathering many, many scans of the sample or otherwise adjusting the acquisition parameters. We have now discussed some of the consequences of the low abundance of the C13 isotope. If you like this video, please leave a like and/or subscribe. Leave any comments, questions, or feedback in the comments section. Take care.